Hello, welcome back to Ascendant with Bearded Narwhal. Yesterday we beat the game. That was probably the worst intro ever, but yeah. If you missed yesterday's episode, go check it out. Rank 2 Bearded Narwhal. I don't know if I can ever beat Kvith Bjorn, but so be it. But today, we're going to take kind of a different route, and we are going to play... Who do I want to play today? I actually think, hold on. I pressed start with a mouse, and it wanted me to use mouse and keyboard. Start game. That'd be an interesting challenge run, play multiplayer by myself. We're gonna play baby mode with Gott. Why not? There's kind of a celebration, if you were. Also, we need to get on the leaderboards. For baby mode. So I've changed my audio balance, and I wouldn't, like, Ascendant seems crazy quiet right now, so I'm actually going to turn up the volume with which that records, and I hope that fixes that. If it's a little too loud, I apologize now, but I had adjusted my audio settings after recording Crypt yesterday, and I recorded Binding of Isaac, and the game is super quiet, which is unfortunate, because I had such an, like, a super run. If you don't watch my Binding of Isaac series, this is one of the few episodes that I actually recommend watching. It's awesome. Also, I think baby mode has more health drops. That seems to be a theme of this run so far. Also, enemies have, like, no health. And they only deal a quarter heart. Oh my god. Oh, baby mode. Okay. Is it gonna give us the best items in the game as well? I hope so. This is a celebration run, but I'd kind of feel cheated if I, Wow, okay. I don't even know where I was going there with I don't remember where I was going with that sentence, but 30 mana on floor 1 is pretty good for Gott. And let's fight whoever's in here. Son of Grunty! You know, I'd actually kind of think that they would take Son of Grunty out of baby mode. Honestly. I think he is possibly the hardest boss you can fight early on, so. I guess they're not taking bosses out, they're just making them easier. Yeah, he has a lot less health. So it looks like we can beat him in 2 passes. That's pretty good. But yeah, if you watch Binding of Isaac and you haven't yet, go watch it. Well, this is going up before Binding of Isaac, so if you do watch Binding of Isaac and you happen to be watching this before, get excited. It's fun. I won't tell you what happens, but, you know, Binding of Isaac-y things happen, and with Community Remix mod, things can get pretty fun. Anyway. Late spring. But yeah, expect my audio levels in Binding of Isaac to be really poor. It's unfortunate, but... Also, I haven't even mentioned yet, we got the split shot upgrade from that last room, and that's awesome. It's like the perfect Gott weapon, because you could just be like floating artillery. Oh my god, so much health. Is that? Wow, okay. I didn't expect there to be a ceiling on this room, I guess it makes sense with that there. Oop. Woo! Wow. Yeah, I think if I beat it this time, this will be the last time I play baby mode. Unless I'm feeling, like, really down on myself. I mean, I'm glad they added an easier mode, because I feel like it may have been a little less accessible to newer players, you know? I mean, I probably wouldn't have started on baby mode out of pride, but... I don't want it to mean, like, no one should start on baby mode. There's players of all different skill levels playing video games, and I think it was a very smart move on the developer to recognize that. Alright. Especially in a genre like this, the roguelike community and game collections are not exactly forgiving to new people. Like, God, Binding of Isaac destroyed me when I first started playing that, but I mean, I guess I shouldn't say it destroyed me. The first time I played Binding of Isaac, I don't know if I've ever told you this story, my roommate and our friends were downstairs playing Binding of Isaac, and they were having some failure runs. And I came downstairs to see what they were doing, and I had never played it before, so they asked if I wanted to play since they were all losing. And I sat down, and I got, like, a crap ton of good items, and I ended up beating Mom for the first time on their save file. And they were, they were happy for me. I could tell it was a little upsetting, though, that they were struggling to beat the game, and the first time I picked up Binding of Isaac, I ended up winning on a fluke. Especially since I went to every single curse room, which, at that time, they didn't really, do that. At least my friends didn't. They kind of played it safe. If you know anything about me, I tend to not play it safe. Speaking of not playing it safe, let's go to the challenge room as opposed to opening up that chest. We can pick up some health down here, somewhere. I don't know. I think Gott is, like, the best demigod for this because he still adds a little bit of risk because he has a... Yeah, I'll play this a couple times. One more time. Oh, come on. But yeah, he has that occasional double damage against himself sometimes, so, like... You know, we'll pick up one more. We'll try again. Damn. Okay. I can't justify doing that. But yeah, Gott takes double damage every once in a while. And that's risky. Even on baby mode, because what if you take a couple explosions that double damage? That's never good. Yeah, I am using half of this to play again. I never learn from my mistakes, you know that. Don't try to change me and just accept who I am as a player. That's good. Ah, okay. I was hoping it was Osiris. I guess I should have waited for the boss fight to use it because it's a higher chance that it's a other effect, but you know, I've had it pay out with Osiris before, so. Okay, so. Oop. Oh, come on. Here we go. Good night, sweet burrower. Grand Bois! Double the value of hearts. So, what is Ben gonna do? Ben is gonna risk our lives. It's baby mode, come on. If you don't, like, shake it up a little bit, it's not gonna be that fun. Boop. Nice. Come on. So. Okay. One more play and we're done. Okay, that's a weapon. Pack rat, magnetic. Gain a quarter heart after picking up a key. Increased blink range. 45 more damage. And a much faster swing speed. So. I'm content with that room. I hope you are as well. It's kind of silly. A little bit of a cheeky play there since I got Grand Bois. That's exactly what I was hoping for, because Chulainn, being God, gives us more Armored Hearts, and we have Grand Bois now, which can double the value of Armored Hearts. So hold on 1 second while I take a drink. Refreshing. Maybe I should contact Fanta and Mountain Dew and pitch a teamwork effort with them. Every time I take a drink in between seasons, I like turn on face cam and hold it in front of me. No? I actually think Fanta and Mountain Dew are opposing companies. I think Fanta is Coke and Mountain Dew is Pepsi, so... Oh! Nope. Wow. Okay, baby mode. Gonna be that way, huh? Alright, so... There we go. We should be okay. Nice. I wonder what monsters cannot spawn in baby mode. Or if that's even a thing. I'd assume, since they make harder enemies come earlier, they should make harder enemies come later in baby mode. That would make sense, right? Alright. Hmm. Everything definitely has less health. Ooh. Give us... Okay. It didn't double, but... You know what? That's fine. Lots of influence on this floor. If we could find one key, this shop could be very good, because we could buy an armored heart, it could possibly double, and we could buy a red heart, and that could possibly double as well. Oh, secrets. There's that key, and keys give us armored hearts because of our current weapon, so get excited. Really. I don't know what it is with these ninja girls and not wanting to go through worms, but I feel like they did before. Well, let's not go the bottom way. Remember when I got trapped under there and was being bounced into the spikes? That was fun, wasn't it? Alright. I hate those cloud bouncers, but I had to do it to get back to the shop. 154. We can buy basically anything from here. Chakra Barrage. Doubled that, and did not double that. Magnetism. Higher blink range. Not super useful. We'll buy Chakra Barrage. That's pretty good. And I guess we should go to the event room next, since it's unlocked. We have a lot of armored hearts. Look at us go. Oh man, if I won all three games today, I'd be super happy. Oh, okay. Whoop. Okay. So long as we don't really take damage on this, I'd be happy. Okay, that's a max health upgrade. I am fine with that. It'd be kind of cool if Grand Bois could double health upgrades as well. I know they technically count as stat upgrades, not hearts, but I mean, I guess that would make Grand Bois too good. I think it'd be cool though. Don't know why I'm laughing like that this episode. I'm just, I'm pretty giddy about the other things I've recorded today. There we go. Finally a doubled red heart. Okay, so, late maw, not so bad. We should be okay. Especially if we can get in there like that. There we go. Oh, that was good. Snuck up on me there. Okay, we've got one more round of maulings and then we're good. Alright, we double parried there. I'm learning to tap parry instead of just parrying once, because that way we could possibly parry two different ones. Spells launch staggered enemies, additional dash. I'll go with the additional dash for now. We probably won't keep it, but it's fine. Oop. Alright. If I could get the Blessing of Talok, I would be super happy. Late summer. Moving right along here. Feel like we should almost speed up our pace. But, I mean, we don't have anything super stellar on this run. Let's not act like we've got the twig, which we don't. Or God, which is almost not like at all having the twig, but we do have extra spell damage. That's not nothing to be sneezed at. So demon pots exist now. Two demon pots. It's making up for lost time. Okay. Nope. Get in there. Okay, so we already have a whole bunch of red hearts on this floor. Come on. Playing like crap tonight. Sorry. So, I don't know when, but sometime this week, Amber and I are going to play Crawl again. Mainly because the audio balance was terrible in that video. Not, like, the opposite problem of Binding of Isaac. You couldn't hear us almost at all. But we had fun. Amber kicked my butt. We had fun. Alright. Oh, you can do this. Aha! Oh, I can do it. And I did. Wrath, blessing damage up. That could be very good, depending on the items I get later. Oh. This is the perfect secret for God. Because he can just do that. Nice. Nope. Come on. And let's go up here, get our chest. Let's unlock it. That's fine. Oh my God. Grand Bois has been helping us out a lot this run. I feel like they would add more defensive items to baby mode, which makes sense. Not like new items, I mean just like the frequency with which you can get hearts and defensively focused items is probably enhanced, so at least to some extent. Red automaton shouldn't be a huge issue. Oh. That was a very good start. It was scary, and then we pulled it out. So we're good. I was trying to be cheeky there. And like get in there and hurt him with his own, hurt him with both sides of our spell, and then we got hurt. So that was brilliant on my part, obviously. Yeah, when you get Loki and you have a got run, put it on your spells. This has been your Bearded Narwhal PSA of the day. Only you can prevent misuse of Loki. Alright. If we get a Loki piercing Kali run, I'd be so happy with our situation. Alright. That'd be two very similar runs in a row, but it'd be fine. There we are. And our shop. Give us something good. We have enough money to buy basically anything. The Jailer, Lesser Astral Mine, Heal After Unlocking. That maxed out our Armored Hearts. I'm happy with that. Wow. Ah. So we technically have 10 hearts right now. If we found another gambling machine, I would spend so much health on it looking for a twig. Or any orange weapon, really. Because our spells are good enough right now, honestly, that we could get a completely non-spell related weapon, and we'd still be fine. because that would just mean we're well-rounded instead of normal twig runs, which are obviously skewed in one fashion. Thank you for letting me know there was a chest here. A bad one. We probably could have made that if I didn't float down for a second. I'd forgotten we had a second dash. It's fine, though. We don't have another key to go in there, unfortunately, so we leave. Look how much health is on the map. I can't put my cursor on the screen like I do with Binding of Isaac, but that is pretty insane amounts of health. That has to be some augments of baby mode. Alright, I'm gonna take a drink. I'm sorry I always, like, go, when I take a drink, but old habits. Also, I don't do that normally. Like, if you're out to lunch with me and I, like, take a bite, I'm not one of those dudes that, like, goes, no matter what. I feel like I just, like, need an audio cue for everything I do when I record. It's a habit I'll get out of eventually. I know it's probably annoying listening to me every break. Like, I'm not very pleased with my soda, but I am. The soda's doing its own job. I'm proud of it. Thank you. So much health. Every room we've been to on this floor has had health on it, so don't discount my theory that baby mode makes it a little easier to get health. That's probably in the notes for baby mode, and I just didn't read anything. But there we go. A key so that we can visit this. Why, thank you, that's so kind. Crippling poison. Okay. Stop it. There we go. Health upgrade. Super nice. That way, now we can max out at 12 hearts, I guess, with armored hearts. The blessing of Loki with chakram items is really just funny because you can hit people at really strange angles. Like that. I feel like it's one of those drawing tops that you played with when you were a kid. Or at least I did. I don't know. Like, you never know what it's gonna make. It's probably a spiral, but you're excited every time, even though it's the same shape, generally. Unless you had one of those stencils for it. We didn't. I feel like it should come with stencils. Maybe we got it secondhand. I don't know. Just don't remember having them. Maybe my brothers hid them or broke them. Or maybe I ate them and I don't remember. That's possible. I mean, I was pretty young. Don't judge a child for putting stuff in his mouth. That's just kind of how babies feel around in the world for the first couple years. They're like, oh, what's this? It's interesting. I'm gonna eat it. And then they learn when they break their tooth on a Lego. That's not a personal story. I did not break my tooth on a Lego. I'm just saying that's probably a thing that's happened to babies. In fact, I'm pretty sure that's a super likely thing to occur. But I don't want to, like, make it sound like Legos are dangerous. Legos are great. I'm just saying. They're hard. Children like putting objects in. I'm not gonna finish that thought. That was a very weird tangent that I'm not gonna follow up with, but we just got piercing shots, so get excited. We're gonna finish this floor out. Hopefully the audio is loud enough so that you can enjoy it too. I'm actually gonna turn it up a little more. It's kind of quiet even for me. Oh, the entire computer's volume was low. That explains that. Is that a little better? It should be. It's kind of weird. Yep. Spell piercing. Nothing there. Wow. Spell piercing's good, by the way. I don't know if you've heard about it, but look at that. The spells just keep going until everything is dead. And more influence. If we could find another key, that'd be great. That means we can visit the shop for another floor. Come on. Yep, just line up for me, that's fine. It keeps giving us upgrades, which is good. Don't get me wrong, I'm not gonna look a gift horse in the mouth. I just really want to be able to buy a spirit on this floor. Even if it's a bad spirit, it takes it out of the pool of spirits to appear. I don't know if spirits disappear just by seeing them. I'm pretty sure they don't, though. Come on. You know you're gonna die, just come out. Thank you. What's this? Okay, Balor is a good breath, but I feel like Granbois is better. Four hearts of healing, I think, beats one. I don't know. Bonus something. Beats one boss down, I guess is what I should say. Balor is like a really good boss killer, but I'm not gonna leave this out of behind. Okay. That mauling actually activated that for me. I didn't have to do anything. Come on. Thank you. Another health upgrade. So now we have 7 on our first bar, so that means if we find any more health upgrades, we are actually going to go and move into our second bar of health, which is always a very good sign. We just showed you what that looks like. Unfortunately, we didn't get a key, but exploring the rest of the floor meant we got 2 more health upgrades, at least, along with a couple stat upgrades that I failed to mention, but I mean, we're pretty powerful, so I'm excited for the rest of this run. Hope you are too. I don't know. I mean, if this weren't baby mode, I would know exactly where I gauge this run. And I would say it's like strong, but not strong enough to beat the game. In baby mode, I think we're actually strong enough to beat the game, which sounds a little cocky, but piercing, Loki, double shot, chakra barrage, 8 health, Granbois to double health pickups. I don't know. We're doing pretty good. It's hard to knock this run. We actually have a very strong sword, too. Like, unexpectedly strong. Over double our first weapon's damage. Like, we haven't been using it, but that's because our spells are undoubtedly better. Like, that's really hard to top. There's more health on the ground in case we lose any. Alright, guys. There you go. There we go. It's really hard to see us taking much damage now that we have so much going for us. Like, we can just pop down there. And yeah, we took one heart of, like, a quarter heart of damage. But did you see how much of that room we cleared? And whenever we pick up any form of healing, we have a chance of doubling it like we just did. It's pretty good. Alright, so that little corner of the floor is done. Let's just go up, see where we can go from here. There we go. More health on the ground. Ooh. Oh, no one's up here. That's kind of a waste. It's okay, then. Okay. Oh, there's 2 of you. There you are. Let's go check out this event room and Hermes. Nope. We already have one of you, and we don't really utilize it very much. Just walk a couple feet, throw another volley of it, keep walking, throw another volley of it, and then just watch it take out most of the room. And we found the chest again. Alright. Give us something good. That's pretty good. It's less damage, but it has the savior effect on it. Heal a quarter heart after picking up a stat boost. I actually kind of like what we have now. It's... I mean, technically, yes, it's more damage, but I prefer the healing on keep the armored hearts on key pickups to the healing on stat pickups, because it'll be more applicable to get, like, armored hearts than to get normal hearts, in our current run, at least. Normally, I'd disagree with myself and be like, well, red health is... stat upgrades are a lot more common than keys, and I'm like, well, yeah, but... I mean, when's the last time we took actual red heart damage? It's been a while, right? Boop. Okay, there you go. One more event room. We still haven't found the shop. But once again, we have enough money to buy whatever it gives us. Okay. Okay, we just killed a lot of these guys. You lost one? You certainly are. So health upgrade and an armored heart. Armored heart doubled. We now have 5 armored hearts of protection. Awesome. And if you're wondering why we get 2.5 armored hearts when that doubles, it's because Chulainn normally gives you a bonus half armored heart when you pick up armored hearts, and when we double it, that means he gives us an extra heart in general. Ooh. Okay. More armored hearts, I guess. There we go. That's... like, the best breath you can see in here. Spirit of the Swift, speed up, disruption, spells ignore shields, doesn't really matter. Takes them out of the pool, though. Chakram Volley, we already have Chakram Barrage, speed and jump up. So we're just gonna be super fast now. I guess that's fine. I'm kind of worried about how fast we are. At least we don't have the speed up after dashing. Because that's super disorienting, especially when you have a double dash. And just you up here, I guess. Wow. Very cozy run so far. And it just keeps getting cozier. I feel like these rooms would have green stompers already. I don't really know what they're called. 10 max mana is very nice. I don't know what those guys are called. The big golem dudes that chuck stones at us. I feel like these rooms would be filled with those guys on a normal run, or especially on a rage mode run. And it'd even have the green ones as well. Wouldn't just be the easy brown golems. Or red, I guess. We got another health upgrade. It's very good. Okay. Go ahead. Wow. So, first phase of this fight went by very easily. You could just hide under him during that portion? How have I never known that? Okay, we already hit him with that, so he's just gonna pop out now. Yeah, how have I never known you could just hide under here? That seems like the most useful information. Okay, so he's gonna pop out again. Yep, there we go. Hallor. Sure. Now when we dash, we fire our bouncing, piercing spells. I decided to get rid of our double dash. I think it's worth it. Let's get out of here. Interesting run. I'm gonna take a drink. 34 minutes in and we're already in early winter. Man. Kind of wish I had the cartographer. or like the compass version of Kamoho so that we could just automatically find our way to where we want to be. I couldn't see the exploder guy there. There we go. Still a guy left, huh? We killed him with our dash shot. That's what I was testing. Obviously, it would just be safer to spam. However, it makes our escapes very thrilling because we could just shoot people. It, key means not a half armored heart, maybe a quarter. I don't know. Really? You were just waiting for me up here, huh? More spell damage. Always welcome on this kind of run, where our spells are already kind of the star of the show. It's not even me anymore, it's, really. Really, it's never me that's the star of the show. Normally, it's the game. I'll be honest there. There you go. Holding you down. Please die. Who's left? Ow. And we're done with this corner of the floor. We got a couple stat upgrades. Is it worth all the armored hearts we lost? Probably not. That's fine, though. I don't know what demigod we're fighting, but it seems like it's gonna be okay. If the boss's health are reduced by the same amount as normal enemies, we should be perfectly fine. Because right now we're only dealing 66 per ring, which isn't stellar, but we seem way more powerful than you'd think we would be on this run. Okay. Okay. There we go. Where are you? Really? There you go. What is this? Taskmaster. Now we can tame flies. Not really in the spirit of this run. It's fine though. Ooh. I guess we found our shop already. So. Nope, we found a blessing room, or an event room. We found another health upgrade. Let's find out what's in here. Okay. Can we do it again? Yeah, we can. How long does it take for him to give you his freaking spirit? Or his blessing, rather. It's kind of a lot of effort there. There we go. The reason I did is because we have so much health over the course of this floor that we can just go pick it up. We'll be fine, basically. Which I'm gonna do now. We don't have low health equals damage, so saving it until later is worthless. There we go. Unfortunately for us, Chulainn does have a negative effect in that he lowers the amount red hearts heal you, but the fact that we have Grand Bois kind of evens that out because we can double red heart pickups. Yes. Whoop. Come on. There we go. There you go. So many chakram. This is insane. I mean, I've seen runs like this before, but they've never felt so strong. And yes, I know it's because we're not on normal mode. It's fine, though. I'm allowed to have fun on this run. There we go. Health up. Or rather, just red health. I hope this is the way to the shop, because if it's not, we're probably just going to go fight our boss and leave. At this point, I'm in the mood to just run through the rest of the game. Oop. the chest. It's not a shop. Another Breath of Balor. Okay. See you later. So, I guess both the shop and the boss fight are to our left. If I see both of them at the same time, I'll be super happy. Because that way, I won't have to make a decision. I can just go into the shop before we leave. Okay. There we go, let's keep going up. Nice. I guess the shop is one more floor up. Let's go do it. Trying to be cute with our dodge spells, but I should probably just cast. Alright, there we go. We heal when unlocking stuff, so that's actually kind of useful. Armored Heart. Cartographer, that gives us a map for the next floor at least. And make sure that we don't get it on the chest, or the astral rather. So this adds two more to each ray, but it also lowers our base damage on it. I think it's worth it. We hit two more times per burst. So, and mana's not really an issue right now. If we really run out of mana, we can just Balor away. By that I mean dash, and we'll shoot a free spell. Only in one direction, though. Not the Kali Blessing does not apply to the dash spell, which I guess makes sense, because it's affecting us, not the Eye Balor. But I feel like it'd be cool if these synergized a little more. Here we go. Nice. Okay. Don't know why I decided to challenge that guy to melee combat, but I did. Spell damage. Where are we at now? 59 per. That's not super great. It's okay though. So Gilgamesh. What we're gonna do here is wait. And then... Yeah, our damage isn't great here. I feel like Gilgamesh is very strong, though. And that's why our damage isn't super good. At least that's the excuse I'm gonna give myself to make myself feel a little better about this run. Parry. So he's gonna summon something. Flies. Did he just... Whoa! There you go. See you later, Gilgamesh. More piercing. Sure. That's the first time I think we've ever gotten two Itzli blessings and not put it on our body slot. It's pretty interesting. I think at this point it's actually bad to put it on your body slot, because then you get used to having that protection, and on the next run you're just gonna like jump around and die to spikes. A normal person wouldn't have that problem. I totally do. Also, did you see that sweet effect above her head when I hit her with my melee attacks? Itzli. What is that? Is it? Yeah, attacks may petrify foes, not do petrify foes. There we go. Chests. There's a heart. Let's go to the left really quickly to see if the shop is below. If not, we'll just skip that particular stage. I can't tell if it's locked or not. It is not. Unless it's a event room. It is an event room. Okay. Lou offers respite. So we're not going to pick that up until we are in trouble. I don't even know if we're going to be in trouble in this run, though, so... I'm not going to hope that we get hurt so that we can use that, but it kind of seems silly that we found one of the best rooms in the game, healing-wise. Or, I guess, run protection-wise. And we can't pick it up. 10 more mana is always nice. Come on. Something nice. I would have even been fine with a blood shop there. Speed and blink up. More speed, huh? Oh, I actually think this is better than what we have. Not damage-wise. It's going to lower our damage more. Again. But now we can get super long-range piercing dynamite run. So, I'm fine with this. I hope you're okay with that. This is a higher mana cost spell, so we're not going to be able to cast it as much. But look at the crazy stuff we can do. Okay, yeah, we did run out of mana there. Yes, you have a point. Get off my back, though. Alright. There you go. How's that feel? We shoot so many spells. There we go. Wow. And boop. Come on. That, I don't think, is our boss fight. Why did I even attack him? We can just do that. What is our boss room? Let's check out our chest and then let's go. Talok. It's good. Not super good, though. So we're gonna leave it. Humbaba. Hey, buddy. Oh. So we didn't quite get Armored Heart Humbaba to show up, but that's fine. Okay, there's Spirit Heart Humbaba. By that, I mean Humbaba when he goes invincible. That's always like a good baseline sign for your run. Just kill him now. Give us our chest. Hermes. Cool, we're gonna ignore that. Let's go down a couple rooms. Pick up this heart, perhaps. Is that it? Nope, there's more on this floor. Where is it? There you are. And then let's go over here. Pick up this. I guess we could go all the way over and pick up that healing room. Yeah, let's do that. No point in wasting a red heart. Oh, there we go. So, the loot room ended up not being useful. That's fine, though. Someone else will find him useful, I'm sure. That's not how that works. There's not someone else on this seed. Although, wouldn't that be cool? Two people progressing on the exact same seed. I mean, people do that for Binding of Isaac, but I feel like Ascendant would have a very interesting, like, meta for that, because like it's not guaranteed they're playing the same person. It's not guaranteed that they get the same shop items. Well, they'd have the same shop items, I guess, if the seed is the same, but I don't know. I feel like that'd be very different. Extra armored hearts when we get it is very nice. Itzley, also very nice. Here we go. Yep. There we go. Yes. Nope. Oh, nice. We have our little fly doing action over here. Hey, where are you? Just gotta make it rain, I guess, and then we'll be good. Nice. Let's hope our spirits in the future are really good too. Like if we could get the blacksmith upgrade, it would be very, very useful for us. Now that we get like so much extra armored heart. How did we not take damage to that fire? The mysteries of this game.
There you go.
Okay, he's petrified. Good. Die. Thank you. Petrified. She is petrified. Nope. There we go. Oh, it was so strong. We're very, very fast on this run. Okay. I think he's the last enemy. He is. And now we move on. I'm very surprised by how little damage upgrades we've gotten over this run. We're only doing 52 per strike, but we're still acting like this run is very easy. Okay. Shoot at us. Okay, there we go. Okay, he actually gave us time to recover our mana, which was nice of him. Okay, quite like the Hermit. You can, I guess, wait under the maw, which, how am I just finding these things out on this run, on baby mode? I guess now that I'm, like, safe to experiment, since it is baby mode, is good. There we go. Ooh, that could be good. I think double's better, but that could have been good. So we're gonna leave that, unfortunately. That's fine, though. So let's jump over these. And that is Scavenger, no pot is safe. The reason I'm leaving those is because we have the chance to double hearts. So if we took those now, we could potentially be wasting some. If we get hurt one more time, we'll go back and check on them, but in the meantime. Wow. Just peek our head in and kill your entire room, why don't we? Okay, stay. Thank you. He was petrified, which is why he just kind of stood there. Okay, that guy didn't die. No, he did. Poor guy. Nice! Max health, even this late, is so good. If we could get that spirit that increases our damage based on how low our health is, the maniac. How can I never internalize that? If we could get that, our run would be pretty much set, because even if we start taking really bad damage, we would just get health. We would get damage for it, is what I was trying to say. Oop. Alright, kill this guy before we forget about him. Nice. I feel like late game, it would have been better to have Chakram Barrage. But right now, I feel like it's fine that we traded for this one. Because we can snipe people with it. Okay. I think our flies can handle it, even if that guy didn't die. Come on. Are they not handling him? Oh, there was just one fly up there left. Alright, so one more room and then we fight the boss, which is Burrowward Part 1. Which I think we can certainly use our spells on, because our first flurry of them will not kill them at all. Nice. Is there another? Oh no, he was just petrified when he was on the ground, so I guess it just kept him that way. Oh no, there's another one. Okay, Thank you for petrifying so many people. Itzley, that is actually a lot better of an effect than I thought it was. I don't know why I thought petrification wouldn't be a good ability. Honestly, I had no idea what it would do for us, because to me, petrification kind of seems like they die, like they just stone in the background now. Now it's kind of like, oh, that makes sense, they just can't move. They don't even turn gray, they just have an Itzley symbol floating above them laughing. I feel like it's more akin to like Tasha's hideous laughter from Dungeons and Dragons, but that's just me. Okay, come on. Okay. Oh, petrified. Alright, just this guy left. Let's try to keep him intact so we can do that with him. One more hit. Nice. Yes. I know it's a really small chance, but there is a chance that we could get... Oh, damn it. There is a chance that we could get a very good spirit later in the game. Ooh. Please die. Our damage is starting to, like, reveal itself. It's not very good. The only reason we're winning this run is because the Loki bouncing combo is the Loki pen bouncing combo is really good. So, if I lose, let it be blamed on that, not me. That's all I'm trying to say. Okay, so what bosses do we have left? We have Automaton, which shouldn't be too bad. We have Hermit, and then we have Max Man is nice. And then we have the boss. Okay. That's not that much left to do, so I think we're in a pretty decent place. Thank you for petrifying him. There we go. Come on. Thank you. You're trapped. Thank you. Alright. The more flies we convert, the faster floors go. I was very lucky that he got knocked out of my range. I don't know if it was my launch that did it, or if it was one of my flies, but I'm very happy he did not explode. On me, at least. He did explode. Okay, more spell damage. Good. 54. Keep it up. Okay. Oh, look, an influence grunty. That's super useful, right? Sarcasm 101. I mean, it's fine. It's not like it's a bad thing, it's just a late thing. Whoop. Come on. Nice. Losing a lot of hearts. That's fine. We'll be okay. He said before throwing. We do have Grand Bois, so remember that. Oh. I think green and orange automaton at this point are no different, so don't worry too much about his coloration. Oh. Those orbs are gonna be super nice. Yep. For that reason, they block his fire orbs. And then he destroys all of them. There it is. Ah. Okay. just a couple more. There we go. I'm pretty well, I'd say. I'd be tempted, but I think we're good the way we are. Okay, Spirit of Luck, we feel lucky. About what? I'm not sure yet. I've never confirmed what it actually means to be lucky in this game. Midas is lucky. I wish that meant his passive would never go off, but... Alright. 5% melee damage. Nice. Ooh. Okay. Petrification apparently made that guy go through the ground, but that's normal, right? Okay, get out of here. Very good. Let's keep it up. Let's kind of limit the amount of damage we're taking now, because we're nearing the end of the game and we don't want to toss it away. Especially on baby mode. There we go. One more floor. And after this, I may actually backtrack all the way to the beginning. Game minimized, I apologize. But I may backtrack all the way to the first stage to pick up the 3 hearts I never picked up. I think it'd be silly to not, unless we get something super awesome right before the boss, which is doubtful, but... Like, if we got another Grand Bois breath from a chest, which has happened, we didn't. So, we're backtracking for a second. You might want to fast forward a little bit, because I know backtracking can be tedious, but I feel like it's our best option here for victory, and I don't want to throw it away just because I'm lazy about backtracking, so... I'm taking faster routes. Never fear. Can I not go back? Yeah, I can go back. That was weird. Alright, here we go. We get to see all the stuff we left behind, too. Oof. The astral plane is so, like, soft. If that makes sense. Like, you'd think the, like, neon lights and stuff would be, I don't know, like, straining on the eyes, but I feel like it's very peaceful. Like, we're at the middle of the world tree or something. Everything just makes sense in the astral. Yes. The music helps. If it was, like, really heavy techno or something like that, I feel like it might lose its charm, but... I don't know. The way it is, very peaceful. Inviting. Okay, so that helps. Let us through. Okay, not sure what's making it hard to go through those gates, but something is. Okay, there we go. Whoop! And the reason I'm doing this now is because you can't backtrack after you do the hermit fight, so... Take that as you wish. Did we leave hearts on this one too? I think we might have. Yeah, we totally did. Yeah, I'm not gonna backtrack all the way to the first stage. Now that I have... Now that I'm only missing three-fourths? Yeah, of a heart. I say it's worth it to kind of not backtrack. It's only one more floor, but at the same time... Yeah. This is me just after talking about how backtracking is worth it and how it never pays to be lazy in this game, and I'm being lazy. It's fine. If we lose by one heart, I'm sorry, but be okay. I promise. Alright, so I guess we get to fight the hermit now, and now that we know the new strategy of just sitting right under him unless he melee attacks, I think we're gonna be okay. How have I not noticed you can do that with the Maw and Hermit? For some reason, I'm used to enemies always dealing contact damage. Like, if you run into them, you always take damage. That's not the case in this particular game, though. Oh, wouldn't it be cool if there were an item that could break down barriers between rooms. Like, you see how all these rooms are touching on the minimap on the top right? Wouldn't it be cool if there was an item that lets you go through once or something like that? Like a breath? I don't know. I think that'd be cool. You could skip an entire boss. You could skip right to the boss fight from here. Final boss fight, rather. It's a very big, high-risk, high-reward scenario. It might be a little too overpowered, kind of like the shovel in The Binding of Isaac, but it'd be interesting to see that kind of item in this game. I don't know if that's the kind of gameplay aesthetic they want to use on this game, but I maintain it'd be cool. Hello, Hermit. Okay, just sit underneath him. Alright. Oh, we got a friend. Okay, orbs. Let some rocks through. There we go. There we go. That turned out pretty well. Oh, is that ours? It is ours. Nice. Alright. Don't get distracted by the pretty colors. Kill the hermit. Nice. Hit the ceiling again, please. You made the sound early. Nice. Just gonna do it again, though. Very good. Goodbye, Hermit. Hello, Zephyr. Bye, Zephyrs. Alright, let's see if there's a blacksmith here. Fear the Maw, so we summon poison. Or the toxic spittle, I guess. Ah, we should have waited until we got hurt. That's fine, though. We could take Hachiman, it would double our damage for a short amount of time, which could prove very useful against the boss. I think 4 health is better, because we could kind of ration out our time a little better. Awesome. Ooh. Is there an exploder there? I think there was. That would certainly explain what went on there. There we go. Okay. We need to start using our melee attacks a lot more, because when we're running out of mana, we're just kind of sitting there, and that's not exactly the best way to handle this game. Alright. Luckily, we just got more mana, so those times when we are out of mana are going to be less frequent now. Okay. That must be how we took damage for no reason there. There was a demon pot right in front of us. Nice. Oh, we heard someone over there. No, we didn't. Oh, okay. Please continue doing well. I think there's only one room left after this. Yes. Oh. Slayer. Damage versus boss is up. Hello, Osiris. Good to see you around. I totally forgot we had that. And, that's possibly, like, the best spirit we could have gotten at this point. Oh, hey, I heard you were worried about your damage on the upcoming boss fight. Here you go. Thanks, Osiris. If I could have Osiris as a passive on, like, as a spirit, I feel like that would be really broken because it would be a spirit that turns into spirits. So you could get Osiris, which gives you that spirit, which gives you more spirits. A little too good. The only reason I bring it up, or thought to bring it up, is because there are spirits that are duplicated by, like, blessing counterparts. And here we are at the final boss fight. You've made it. This is the road's true end, and your death draws near, for you're just another ant to be toyed with until I grow bored and crush you. In your time as a sentinel, have you caught a glimpse of a certain artifact that is not of your concern? I see, but it would be if I were in your place. The entire world would be. Interesting. Allow me to relieve you of your burden. I love how Gott is on a quest to find an item. He doesn't even care about being God. And then when Chulainn was like, yeah, I mean, you could totally find that if you were God. He's like, oh, well, sign me up. Okay. Okay. So, our damage isn't stellar. It's okay, though. Hey, come on, Will. There we go. We'll be okay. I believe in us. Let's just destroy one of them at least, and I'll feel a lot better about it. Nice. There's one down. Okay. Okay, one, two down. Let's, oh. Exactly what I was afraid of would happen. We were out of mana when we fought him. That blows. Okay. Whoop! Alright. Oh man, I could have totally parried that. What was I doing? Okay. There we go. Sword down. Ooh. There we go. And please go down. Oh, that's a lot better. One more time, I guess. We can do this. We haven't actually taken that much damage, so. Please die. There we go. One out of three down. Not so bad. Whoop. There's a lot of, like, just shots with the blessing, I've realized. Okay. Nice. Okay, let's see what he's casting. Let's try to deal with this with melee, so that if we destroy it, we can just kill our boss immediately. There we go. Alright, so now we have part two, where we fight two parts of him at once. Luckily with our piercing shots, it's not super bad. It's still kind of bad, though, because we're going to be out of mana almost guaranteed when we fight him. Alright. I guess not, because we can just wait until... Yep. This should be fine. We did it. Baby mode clear. So many opportunities for torture wasted. Omnipotence, this is true prize. Don't get comfortable, I will have my revenge. There we go. Beat baby mode. That was an achievement, I guess. I think. Did it? No, it wasn't. Okay. Totally thought it was. So, let's skip the credits. 111. Character locked, character unlocked. So that was baby mode. Let's see where we sit on the time list. Probably really far back, to be honest. Like, I don't even think we'll be on the first page, no. Yeah, we're 12th on baby mode, that's fine. Is anyone else on rage mode now? No, just six of us. Alright, well... Oh, did someone pass me on normal mode? I didn't even check today. Oh man, someone passed me. Grudge match is gonna happen soon. So, that was Ascendant for today. If you enjoyed the video, let me know by liking. If you have any advice or ideas for runs I could do in the future, let me know in the comments section below. And once again, this is Bearded Narwhal, this is Ascendant. I'll see you next time.